Hello, welcome to learn Java language. Java is an object-oriented programming language. All object-oriented techniques are available in Java. For example, class, object, inheritance, polymorphism, constructor and destructor. Basically, Java can be divided into three modules: standard edition, enterprise edition and micro edition. In this lecture, we are going to learn standard edition. Enterprise edition is useful to develop website or web-based applications, and Java micro edition is used to develop applications which are run on mobile phones. Standard edition is an installable software. If you want to install Java in your computer, then you have to install Java standard edition. Latest version is a 7.0. By using this version, you can develop standalone programs which are capable to run on computer, as well as you can develop net-based programs, that is distributed programs which are available on multiple computers through the internet, desktop applications, as well as program to control consumer devices, that is you can write a program to control hardware also. What are the features of Java? Java is a simple language. If you know C and CPP, then it is very easy to migrate Java, because all syntaxes of C and CPP or all syntaxes of Java are similar to C and CPP language, as well as Java don't has pointer concept. In case of C and CPP, we had used pointer to generate or to create dynamic memory, but in Java all things are by nature dynamic, that is array is by default dynamic, therefore you don't have a pointer concept in Java. So Java is a simple language. The next point is robust, that is automatic memory management. Java, the compiler of Java, is capable to manage the automatic memory, that is if in C and CPP if you have a variable and if you did not assign value to it, in that case the variable has by default garbage value. But in Java it is not possible, because garbage collection thread is always active, garbage collection is always activated, and if you try to use variable without assigning value, then at the time of compilation of program, Java compiler gives you a message, the variable might not be initialized. So it is a robust, it automatically manage garbage collection. It is platform independent. Whenever you develop Java application, then that application is capable, or that application can run on any type of platform, that is on any type of operating system. The next point is architecture neutral. The compile code of Java is not machine dependent. So if you change the configuration of your computer system, then also it does not affect the working of Java program. So it is architecture neutral. It is dynamic. Dynamic from the view of website. Before launching of Java, websites are static. Website were static. But after launching of Java, the static nature is converted to dynamic. So Java is a dynamic, or in Java we have a classes through which we can easily develop net programs which are executed on Internet Explorer or any web browser. It is a multi-threaded language, that is you can create a program that arrange multiple tasks, that is multi means many, thread means task. C and CPP being a single threaded language, but in Java you can develop an application to use multi-threading. Threading is already an inbuilt class which is available in Java. So you can easily develop multi-threaded applications which are managed multiple tasks at a time. Java is a secure language. If you use the security classes, then there is internal firewall is generated and it is always activated. If you develop the program under the Java, or if you develop the software under the Java, and if you use a security classes, then it first check the, or its internal firewall is always activated. So if the computer system contain any virus or any viral infection, then your software never download on that system. It is a pure object oriented. All things in Java are enclosed under the class. If you want to create program to display your name as output, then also you need a class. In case of CPP, we have class as well as other part of our coding is under the main function. But here main is also under the class. Therefore, Java is a pure object oriented. One more reason is compile code of Java is not a compile code of Java is a binary code, or whenever you compile the code of Java, then there is dot class file is created and that file is used to execute further programs. There is a close relation between Java and the internet. Before launching of Java, programs or net are static, but by using applet or applet help to develop dynamic programs. Applet is a class available under Java to develop web-based programs. Applet can run on any enabled web browser. Applet can respond to input and user actions. Then what is the history of Java? Java found in 1980. The founder of Java is James Grosslyn. The objective of this language is to develop consumer electronic device, or to control the consumer electronic devices. It is initially known as a Oak language, but after launching www World Wide Web in 1995, user had a problems of portability and platform independence. Then they were found that Java is capable to run, or Java is capable to run on any type of operating system. So in 1995, Java is introduced by Sun Microsystems, but it is found in 1980. But it is introduced in 1995 by Sun Microsystems when the internet is launched. In that case, internet user had problem of portability and platform independence. Then they were found that the Java is capable to solve all these problems. Java is being secure, portable, and platform independent, was found to be capable of addressing large scale problems across the internet. If you install the Java in your system, then there is JDK folder is created. JDK stands for Java Development Kit. All the things needed to compile, debug, and execute Java program or applets or the tools or all the command line tools are available under the JDK folder. Basically a set of command line tools. Here we have a version, but the latest version is 7.0, and this software is freely available at the Sun Microsystems official website. Let us see some tools. Java C stands for Java compilation. It is a compiler used to compile the Java source code. Source code means what? Your dot Java program is compiled by using Java C command. You can also specify their class path. That is where your Java program is stored, is a class path. If the Java program is successfully compiled, then it is executed by using Java interpreter. And it always reads the bytecode, that is dot class file. And if you have an argument, then you can also specify here argument while running the Java program. Here the options means what? Your class path or directory path, etc. The main role to execute the Java program is of JVM. JVM stands for Java Virtual Machine. JVM generates bytecode as a result of compilation. Whenever you compile the program by using Java C command, then bytecode is generated. This bytecode cannot be executed without the JVM. In all operating systems, by default, JVM feature is available. Therefore, on all operating systems, you can run your Java program. It is an interpreter. JVM is an interpreter between the Java bytecode and the computer operating system. Java code can run on any platform by using JVM. Then how to run any program? Because all the operating systems are built-in JVM feature. Therefore, the platform independence feature is available by the Java because of only JVM. JVM normally reads and executes Java statement one at a time. Therefore, if you have a changes in your program, you have to save it and again compile it, because JVM normally reads and executes the Java statement one at a time. JVM responsible for platform independence and small size compile code. It only recognizes binary format, that is a class file. Whenever you successfully compile your program, then there is .class file is created. After using the Java C command, .class file is created, and this .class file is used to execute the program to a Java command. In C and CPP, you have a header files. Header files means what? It is a collection of related functions. But in Java, we have a packages. Packages means what? It is a logical grouping of similar type of classes. If you want to input, you want to perform input operation in Java, then you need a IO class. If you want to handle the database, then SQL class. If you want to create the web page program, then there is applet class is available, or for Windows applications, AWT class is available, as well as you have a java.lang class. By using this class, you have all basic string methods, string oriented functions and classes are available. All these class library are available in Java, or all these packages are inbuilt. Then if you want to use any one package, then you have to import this package within your program by using import command, import java.io. But in this package you have a number of classes, so you have to write import java.io.classname, whatever the class you need. For example, java.io.datainfostream, or for example java.applet.event. Like this, you have to import the Java package as you use hash include in C and CPP. Here in Java you have a packages, and you have to import these packages while creating the program. Okay. In next lecture, we will see the next part.